Hello and welcome to this video tutorial, Gareth here from tastytudes.com. Now it's important to keep in mind that Photoshop can open and save multiple file formats. Later in the course, we will be looking at saving various files in various formats for various media types. In this tutorial, I want to discuss and open a few file types you will need to be aware of as you begin to use Photoshop. Now, don't worry too much if you are not familiar with these file formats right now. You will get more familiar with them as you get more familiar with Photoshop. For now, this will be an exercise for you to get an idea of what to expect and get a little more savvy with using files in Photoshop. So to follow along with this tutorial, you will need to access the Common File Types folder I have prepared especially for this tutorial. This can be found in the Introduction folder in the Project folder. Now you can download this project folder for free. The download link is in the description. So with the project folder open, click Introduction and open the Common Files Type folder, and you should see the files contained. So here we have four file examples. Now, if I just preview these on my operating system, we can see them. We can see that each one of these documents is essentially the same image. But if we look at the file types, we can see they are all different. Here we have a PSD file, a JPEG, a PNG, and a PDF. Now, various file types are often used and prepared for various creative scenarios. Various file types also carry various different image data sizes on hard disk. So the first file here, O1 example, has an extension of .psd. Now this is a Photoshop data file. This is the native Photoshop file format. If you build a document in Photoshop with layers, the default file format will be .psd. If you receive a PSD document from someone else, chances are it will have layer and effect information inside. So let's go ahead and double click this file. Upon click, the document will open up inside Photoshop. So here is the image. And if we look in the layers panel, we can see that indeed this document contains layers. And these layers can be edited. For example, I can click the red bird layer and move this around. I can select other layers or even create new layers. So this document can be edited and saved to come back and make further amends in future. So I'm just going to close this document and come back to the folder. So the next file we have here is O2 example dot JPEG. Now most of you will be familiar with this file format. This is a very common format. This is compatible with most computer software. It's also a format produced by digital cameras and makes up most of the images you see on the internet. So I'm going to go ahead and open this file with Photoshop. Now, unless you have your computer set up to open your JPEG formats with Photoshop by default, you're going to have to open the file manually. So I'm going to right-click on the file and choose Open With and select Photoshop. Upon click, we now have the image open in Photoshop. So here we have the same image as earlier, but if we look in the Layers panel, we can see something rather different. Here we have a single layer, and by default, the layer is called background. Now, this is common when you open a JPEG for the first time in Photoshop. It will more often than not appear as a flat layer called background, and you will also notice this little lock icon placed on the layer too. So this is a single layer. In the last example, we were able to move the elements around. In this case, the only thing we can do would be to use the Photoshop tools to edit, color, and so on. There is nothing we can edit about the nature of the visual structure, unless we start to use the tools in the menu. Whatever circumstance, this image will be used, be it on the website, in motion graphics, or printed, it will look just like this. Now it's important to mention that if I start to build layers in this document instance, for example, create some type layers at the top, or add some shape layers. When you come to save the document, it will then become a new kind of document. As it contains layer information, it will now become a .psd file, a Photoshop data file. More on that later. So I'm going to close this document and come back to the folder. So the next file I have here is called O3 Example PNG. Now, PNG stands for Portable Network Graphics. So like earlier, I'll right click and open with Photoshop. Upon click, here we can see that this image, like the previous, is on a single layer, though this time we can see something a little different about this file. So this is the same image as previous, but this time instead of the blue space on the outside, we have this grey and white grid texture around the image. Now, if you watched the previous video, you should know exactly what this is. This grid texture represents transparent information. In technical terms, the alpha channel. PNG files are often single-layered images that can contain transparent data, an alpha channel. This gives them the ability to be used in certain creative media where transparency, alpha channels, are required. This is unlike the JPEG, which is a full flat raster image that will never contain alpha channel information. If this image is used on the web or for screen graphics, where we can see the grid texture on this image here, this will be transparent. So just like earlier, if I start to build layers in this document instance, for example, create some type layers or add some shape layers, when you come to save the document, it will then become a new type of document. As it contains layer information, it will become a PSD file, a Photoshop data file. So I'll close this document, come back to the folder and look at the next file. So the last file I have here is a PDF. Now PDF stands for Portable Document Format. PDFs are often documents exported from various word processing or desktop publishing programs which are used by printers to make a document. These documents are also distributed around the internet to be read on compatible PDF readers such as Acrobat Reader. PDFs can contain a lot of raster, vector and layered information. Depending on which program you open them with, you can obtain and extract such information. On this occasion, I'm going to right click and choose Open with Photoshop. Now, when you attempt to open a PDF with Photoshop, you will notice something somewhat different happen from the previous files. As mentioned earlier, a PDF can contain various raster, vector and layer information. When attempting to open a PDF in Photoshop, you will not be able to maintain any layered or vector information inside the PDF. When attempting to open a PDF in Photoshop, you will first have to compress and flatten the file. So upon opening the PDF in Photoshop, you will first be greeted with this import menu. This will ask you a few details about how you want to import the PDF. It's here you can specify the image dimension and resolution. On this occasion, I'm going to keep the image dimension the same, but change the resolution to 72 and click OK. Upon click, we will now import the PDF image into Photoshop. And if we reference the layers panel, we can see that this has become compressed into a single layer. Now, it's important to mention that upon importing a PDF into Photoshop, the image that has been compressed and flattened is no longer a PDF. This is now a compressed raster image, which can either be saved as a flat JPEG or edited with Photoshop effects and enhanced with layers. On this occasion, I will close the document and click Not Save. So that is just a simple introduction on how various files can work in Photoshop. There is much more to be learned on this matter and more file formats to explore. But I hope at this stage, this gives you a good insight on what to be ready for when later in the course, we build an entire project from scratch. In the next video, I'm going to be discussing the basics of color in Adobe Photoshop. So see you in the next video.